Today we're going to demonstrate one way to achieve characters' teleportation from one edge of the screen to the opposite side in a smooth, seamless manner. Let's first have a quick look at the code. We've used Auxus project generator called init to make this. By default, new generated projects create a single viewport and a single object and simply check for the quit input in order to quit the application. In this case, we've only done minimal changes to the generated code. First of all, in the init function, we're initializing the random seed order to get different random sequences every time we start our game. Then instead of creating a single viewport, we're now iterating over a list defined in data, which is what we call config, and it's called viewport list. For each item in this list, we'll create a viewport. Next, we've also renamed the name of the single object created in our init from object to scene. However, that change is purely cosmetic. Lastly, we've registered an update function to Auxus' main core clock. This means our update function will be called once per game frame. Let's now have a quick look at the update function. This is where we're going to teleport the characters that reach the screen edges. At the beginning of the function, we retrieve some information stored in config regarding the size and positioning of our camera in the world. We could have hard-coded these values, however, it's a good practice to have them defined in data for better flexibility. Size is self-explanatory and will contain the size of the main camera's field of view. TL will contain its top left coordinate and BR its bottom right one. We'll see the actual values when we have a look at the data in the config file. Once these values have been retrieved, we're going to iterate over all the objects from the group character. That's because we don't want to teleport any other objects in this demo. The code is very straightforward. When a character's coordinate gets outside of the camera's boundaries, we'll adjust it so that it's positioned to the opposite side. And that's it. As you can see, there's nothing in code that will make the transition between opposite edges smooth. If anything, the character should teleport abruptly from one side to the other. And without our special viewport setup, they would. Let me demonstrate by removing any extra viewports and simply keep a single one that also renders the rest of our scene, including the background. After restarting our application, we can now see that our robot characters teleport abruptly from one side to the other, as we would have expected from the code. To make it more obvious, let's double the robot's scale and restart the application once again. Let's now have a quick overview of our config file. This part defines an object we call robot, as well as its animations and other properties like its scale, a random color and position, or its group, in this case called character, as we've seen previously. From that robot, we made four different types, one for each direction, where we give them the animation that matches their movement. Here we have the map object, which is the background we can see behind the robots. As we've given it a parent camera and a scale of 1, it'll match exactly what is seen by the camera, getting stretched or shrunk if need be. We can actually see that in our case it got stretched. And if we remove its parent camera property, we now have a background that isn't scaled to match the camera and doesn't fill the screen anymore. So let's restore it to its former glory. Finally, we can see our scene object and the very one we created in our init function, along with our viewports. When it's created, it'll also create all the objects referenced in its child list property. In this case, we get the map background object and 8 robots, 2 for each direction. We're not going to go into detail of what's defined at the top of the file, such as the inputs or the display settings, as they're not really relevant to this demonstration. What is important is the viewport list property, over which we iterate when initializing our game. We can see, in addition to our viewport, a series of 4 other viewports: viewport left, viewport right, viewport top, and viewport bottom. As you can see, those viewports are associated to cameras that have the same properties as the main camera, except shifted from its original position. In fact, camera left is positioned to the left of the main camera, and so on and so forth. However, given that the camera left renders to viewport left, which is physically on top of the main viewport, anything that gets off screen to the left of the main camera, and thus inside the field of view of camera left, will get rendered to the right of the screen. In fact, we have five cameras laid out in a cross formation that all render on the same screen atop each other. That is how the seamless teleportation is achieved. Let's restore all our viewports and restart the application to check the effect. There are other ways to obtain a similar effect, however, none as simple and less intrusive than this simple trick. In the end, the only code modification we had to make was to create all the viewports from a list defined in our data from the config file. And this demonstrates one way how AUX's rendering pipeline is flexible, as the passes and the render targets can be entirely defined on the data side. This extends to more advanced techniques such as off-screen rendering or multiple render targets, etc. It's also very handy during the development phase to be able to add extra debug viewports without having to modify a single line of code, and we'll demonstrate this in a later video. Thank you.